first section of the race begins at the Gatun Locks and goes to Gamboa. It's generally considered to be the toughest of the 3 days. The racers face 3+ hours of heavy swells and hot sun. The early morning has brought quite a bit of rain to the Atlantic side of Panama, and that hasn't done anything to make the waters any smoother. Some of the racers are hoping that the overcast skies will help keep things cool, at least for the early going. During the night, broken oars were repaired, damaged boats mended, and the God Palante, they're back.
Yeah.
The crew of the Snafu has a small lead over the Miss, and I caught up with them before the morning captain's meeting.
Yesterday, you came in by a second. You think you're going to hold it?
I think we can. If we just stay ahead of the guys, I think psychologically, you know, we'll get them down and we'll be able to beat them.
Angel, what do you think you have to do today?
Row.
There's not a whole lot of strategy to the lake, but physically, it's very demanding. Another runner, the ladies of the Deer Dick. They have a 21-second lead over the Great Expectation.
What do you have to do to stay in first place?
Well, we just have to keep our minds on ourselves. We don't have to worry about any of the other boats. Just keep our heads on straight, and I think we can do it.
Do you prefer rough water or a smoother lake?
Rougher lake.
Why do you think that is?
Because we don't swamp very easily, and so maybe, hopefully, the other boats will and wing it.
Okay, now, I want to ask you about this. You've got a little contraption here. What is this?
Yeah, it's just a water bottle, and the night before, we just freeze it. The night before the lake, we freeze it, and then while it's melting during the lake, we just keep the straw in our mouth the whole time, and that way we have liquids all the time.
Is that important for you, Rachel?
Or else I'm going to die out.
How long do you figure you'll be on the lake?
About 3.5 hours around.
All right, gals.
That's been our average.
Good luck to you. Thank you for stopping by. We'll see you at the end of the race.
Thank you.
The captain's meeting is over and crews are prepping to hit the lake. Last night, they all enjoyed a spaghetti dinner together. It's one of the traditions of Cayuco and shows the camaraderie the team share. Now that their water bottles are in place, the Cayucos are lining up at the starting line. Let's watch as the second leg begins. Midway through today's race, the Misconception has opened up a 1,000-yard lead over Snafu. They're followed by High Anxiety in third, Due Process, and Gon Palante is currently fifth. Earlier today, I talked to the crew of the Misconception.
All right, today in the lake, it's going to be very rough waters. Do you prefer rough waters or smooth?
We've gotten some of our best times in smooth and rough, so I don't think it really matters to us what the conditions are like. It'll probably help us if it's rough because the waves and stuff will push us along, but I don't think it really matters that much.
Brian, last year this boat really tore up the lake from what they tell me, so do you expect to do the same this year?
Well, we practiced really hard, and if all comes through, you know, if everything goes well, we should come up very close.
Now, you are also basically the rudder for this boat. What do you do in the stern?
Well, I basically keep the boat straight, and as straight as you go, the faster you're going to go. The faster you go will be because you go straighter.
What do you have to do today to come out in first place?
I think the thing I have to do is just get out in front and come out of Banana Channel first.
There are some tough luck boats out there. The Utmost has a hole, and their race day is over. This morning, Snafu had a 1 second lead over Misconception. However, Miss has built a seemingly insurmountable 4 minute lead as they head into Gamboa and the finish line. At the end of day two, Misconception has a 4 minute lead over second place Snafu. Other top finishers include High Anxiety in third, then Due Process and Spontaneous Combustion. For the ladies, Great Expectation has an easy day. It's a 10-minute first-place finish over Dear Dick. Again today, the first patch boat to cross the line is Mr. Most. Sunday morning starts early for these racers, but while tired and sore, the kids are excited because they know that the leaderboard can change. After all, anything can happen to a front runner at the starting lines of the Pedro Miguel or Miraflores lot.
At the end of Friday afternoon's first leg, 1 second separated first place Snafu from second place Misconception. Coming into the second day, Misconception felt that they had a pretty good chance to make that up because they're a rough water boat and they're heading into the roughest part of the lake, the Banana Channel. And they were right. They made that up and more as they came out yesterday in first place by 4 minutes over Snafu. Today's race starts in just a few minutes. Now, this is a series of sprints. They'll be going from Gamboa to the Pedro Miguel locks, and then they'll race from Pedro Miguel to the Miraflores locks, and then they'll sit a little bit more, and after that, it's just an all-out sprint to the finish line.